how much effort will I put in? And am I willing to develop the stamina that is usually necessary for anything extraordinary? This means, in business, you have a certain strategy. You want to start a company, so you begin to think about it from very basic point. What you want to do, how you want to go about it. Where's your market? Do you have to create the market? Do you have the capital? If you don't have the capital, are you convinced about your product that other people will loan you money? So you're very intensely involved in those early stages of development, and yet you haven't started yet your company. So it's the same thing. Do I want to do all that? Now, for the businessman, I would say, tell me, how much emotional gratification will you get out of it? And there are many men these days who want to make a change of life, about 50 or 55, sometimes even 60. And there is no easy answer to be given by just the appearance and the way a man talks, because he has learned to do all this through many meetings, board sessions, and what have you. So what you have to do is say, yeah, put it all down and answer these questions. Is your market there? Have you found out? Is there anybody else who does it? And how much capital? Are you convinced about what you want to do? Then somebody else will give you perhaps the assistance financially. If you are convinced by your own personal research, which is reading the life of people, finding out those people particularly, which are closest to your time. There are many great yogis, saints, prophets that have lived in ancient times, and you may feel that there isn't too much that can help you now. But look at the ones who are still alive or have been alive pretty recent. You know, Sai Baba comes to mind. He died 1918. So there are a number of other people that you can look at. You know, and what is their life? What did they do? What can I learn from it? And of course, my uncle here, Shivananda, I have been attracted to him. He didn't do any psychic phenomena. And even so, I had a chance, but I wasn't even prepared to witness it just happen when he was with some children. My attraction was about the character he had. He didn't play any games. He was so straightforward that, even if your ego got hurt, you recognized very quickly that there was nothing else but the ego, the monkey mind playing tricks. And then if you don't want to have any hurts, you put the monkey mind in its place. So, and then you have to watch what happened in your life, whom you meet, how you come in contact with. And you can, of course, also search, but that is a big subject almost by itself, your own unconscious by writing down every morning when you wake up your dreams and find out what they tell you. And the criticism that you have in general for other people reserved, turn it on yourself. All these things are necessary for laying the foundation. But to be still and quiet and understand the mind is necessary to pay attention. You can actually, there's some exercise, you can check your mind every 10 minutes what's going on. You will be amazed about its activity. You may think, well, sleeping 8 hours, do I really need this? Or is it just put down into me? And when I was a little boy, little girl, well, you have to go back to bed now, so you have to have a good rest and sleep, you'll be okay in school. Does it apply to me now? Or will chanting a mantra or a holy song or a holy name of my choice, will that give me enough energy? Can I make it with 6 hours? There's some people who don't do any of those things, they can do it with 4 hours. How come? So if that's possible for others, why should it not be possible for me? You know, you have to think also here, North America is great sports. And I have a couple of students who were secretaries to one organization. And they told me 2 weeks before the game, they have to withhold all the letters, all the phone calls, so that the men are only single-pointed in their mind with the game. And that includes here even celibacy. For those who are married, for those 2 weeks, nothing. All the energy. Well, we demand that in activity, physical activity of sport. And then we say, well, in the spiritual parts, oh no, why should that be? You see, there's no proper understanding and reasoning. And that takes also a while, so you lay a foundation. Jigiri Dharmani Jigiri Dharmani Jigunjavir.